divisions are divided in several departments, and our IT division, we have the department of knowledge management, BIM, for our department, and we have the director of Schuler, the IT. All the other departments, they also have directors from institute at the KIT, so that under logistics and healthcare logistics or the information systems and management. Some big facts and figures about our protein. We had 171 employees and 134 of them are researchers. And in addition to the many working researchers there, we also have 27 school hours and 24 interns. And in 2014, there have been 71 diploma and master thesis and also 13 dissertations. And for a project, in 2014, was 248 projects in total, which have been performed at the SLI, and 111 started. We see ourselves as a transfer of knowledge from research, from KIT mainly, to directors. So we have partners and spin-offs who transfer the knowledge to practice. And we also get the ideas from them. So what's very good in practice and what can be improved. So this is kind of the cycle how we benefit from our partners and spin-offs. And how we can transfer the knowledge from university to practice. What I want to point out today is the quality management. And this is done for the whole research institute. So the idea is that the research institute, the employees are there only for a couple of years. So we have to code somehow with high fluctuation. Nature of our research institute. We want to prevent the loss of expert knowledge or knowledge about administrative processes, and also want to enable the employees to have control of their processes and workflows to share work with them. And this is to increase the efficiency on the work of everyone and to have the structure accessible for everyone. Actually, working with project partners from industry, which are often certified by ISO 9001. We also decided to have our quality management system in a form that fits the regulations of ISO 9001 and also certified. But our research center, every division is certified for the ISO standard 9001. Currently is the revision of 2008. The next audit, there will also be the new draft, which I'll tell you later about. In our division for information process engineering, we implemented the quality management system by Semantic MediaWiki. That's why we have in this case the IPDB-Wiki. The users of the IPDB-Wiki are mainly the employees of our division, of course. It's in our four departments, and each department has different research topic, different understanding, and there's probably 30 employees working with that solution. So, as you've seen before, each department has another director, which has also an institute at the university. So, due to that fact, each professor in each department has a different focus, a different research topics, different terminology, what they are interested in, and also the employees have different cultural or physical background. So the challenge for our IPDB-Wiki is to generate a common understanding for the whole group, for all the different research topics, for all the vocabulary they're using, but to have a common understanding for everyone. So what we did 2 years ago, we look for all the documents which are important for ISO 9001, and we started to replace this document completely by Semantic MediaWiki. So as you can see, this is for example for a project description, which is enforced by by item method 1 to be documented in a structured way. And as we did this here in MediaWiki with the necessary templates and forms, we can ensure that the structure is kept in the proper way. Okay, as a small preview, there's a new revision also that I can have on. Right now we are still certified in the version of 2008. And the new draft is will be out in November 2015. And now we have to double check and to ensure that all the requirements which are defined in the new draft of IP9001 is also fulfilled by our IPE wiki. So many parts are already there, but we have to ensure that everything is alright for the next audit that will be already for the new revision of IP9001. So that we have to ensure that all the requirements are fulfilled by our smart wiki. Also the audits are done on a regular basis, so we have internal audits and also the external audits. And for the new revision, one big change, there are many changes, but one big change is there's more focus on knowledge management, which is quite good that we have the MediaWiki in that case. So, first, the knowledge management itself is more for the customer confidence, so if we work together with our partners from industry, that they can rely on our structure and they find the documents in the expected way. And now with Semantic MediaWiki, we can improve our quality management by knowledge management, which is more for efficient collaboration within the department. But with our Semantic MediaWiki, we can fulfill the requirements for the new draft of the ISO 9001 interoperability. Well, of course, as I showed you before, we are not building only our own stuff. We have more than 200 projects which have to be managed in some way. And as you heard yesterday in that talks, it is still common, unfortunately, that many projects are managed with proprietary documents like Word or Excel. And this was also the case for many projects in our department. The issue about that is that, for example, the Word packages are described with a Word document where you can define your requirements and path and everything in a natural language. But for calculating the effort, you need another tool. So in this case, it was all done by Excel spreadsheets or calculate anything. So we have one document describing our Word package. There's also the result, how much effort is planned for each partner. And on the other hand, we have the Excel spreadsheet where this calculation is done. So the result was that the data was not consistent in many projects. So we have a definition here in the Word document about the effort and the calculation, which shows a different result. So that's also the reason we want to transform that to one unique management tool, very different than Semantic MediaWiki. So Semantic MediaWiki for global management, of course, we can use the basic functionality like the calendar management for deadlines, meetings, milestones, and also do our meeting minutes there, which can be done out of the box. A little more challenging also to implement all the Word packages in a way which fits our requirements. So what we have done for the Word packages, we developed a template, and this template we can use magic forms to get all the required information by the project partner or by the project manager without forcing them to understand every detail of Semantic MediaWiki. And what is done in the template is, for example, the definition of sub-packages. So if a package has a super package, you can vary the package for all sub-packages which are included. So for sub-packages, we can do then a calculation for the whole super package. So when is the first sub-package starting and the last sub-package is finishing? How much is the total effort for all packages? And what's also important to have a small overview, which partner has won which effort for this Word package. So everyone can see in one page, without doing any additional calculation, how much effort is planned for this work package. And also you can interlink the dependencies. So what was a little bit difficult in the Word documents before, it can be done easily here. And so we are able to do all the stuff which was a lot of manual overhead before within one single template. And by using this same template for all our work packages, the overview, which was an Excel spreadsheet before, can now be done with one single Spark query. So with one query, we can see an overview of all the work packages, we see for each partner exactly how much effort is planned, we see who's responsible for the work packages, how much packages are there. We can calculate the total effort by another query. So we can ensure that there are no no differences in the different documents. So to summarize, to sum up, the issues we have solved with our template for the work packages, that we have now a unified approach for describing all the work packages. We don't have to go to different applications to get all the information. We have everything at one single place. Don't have any calculations errors anymore because the project manager does not have to think about how to calculate the effort of everything. Everything is defined in the template. And also important is that we have now a really easy way to edit these work packages in a collaborative way, which is always difficult to avoid Word documents. So many different versions, every partner is submitting another version of the same document. Now, by having only one semantic MediaWiki for that project, we can ensure that there's only one version and we see which partner is created which part of that work package. So we also have consistent data for all project partners. But we have no really a satisfying solution for visualizing the work packages. There are some approaches already, so that is to use the JS Gantt framework for having a Gantt chart. And there used to be also an extension for Smart MediaWiki, there's a Smart Project Management, which is, however, deprecated nowadays. And also the requirements do not really fulfill our expectations. So another option would be the JSWiki Gantt, which is also used for some projects. However, this is static, and what we need is a kind of result format which for MediaWiki, which shows our work packages or the result of our templates in a way where we can generate that overview also for our partners. Okay, another issue for project management is that we have to submit reports to the project leader. So many partners, we have to collect all the contributions of all partners. So what we are doing here, we also have a template for each partner, where we have the structure given, which is required for the document. And each partner can fill his own page with his contributions. And then we can easily gather all the contributions of all partners for one document in the end. However, there's also a little bit ongoing work on this topic. So we had already a discussion in the workshop or yesterday in the conference. There are many solutions to create PDF documents out of Smart MediaWiki. So what we need is kind of matching templates, for example, for special project reports where the format is already given by the project owner. So we have implemented PDF templates or PDF forms and fill it with the data from our Smart MediaWiki. For this year we do have a student project and our students discover that they do some research about all the extensions which are out there and check whether they fulfill our requirements. And in the end, we will have some small overview of what can be done or what is still missing. Okay, there are also some other challenges we still have to solve for our knowledge management in research. So, for example, for each project in our division, we need our own instance for project management as MediaWiki. Now, as we're using only in our division, it's still a handful of numbers, but if you imagine we would use it for all 200 projects in our research institute, that would be too much of only some small instances or some handful of instances of MediaWiki. Another issue that we face is the reuse of vocabulary in all the different MediaWikis. So, when we develop technologies, we want to reuse as much vocabulary as possible, and the current approach to integrate this vocabulary is not really satisfying. What's also missing is the requirement engineering. We also have some research about that, and to develop the requirements in a collaborative way. And yeah, as you can see, that's also the idea of when we extend our wiki family. So let's go more in detail. So for the wiki family management, there are also many approaches, like what kind of role in the workshop on Wednesday, maybe with the Dockers that would be a solution, or there are also in the manual wiki families. A little bit described how we can use shared code bases. However, it's still an issue how to handle all the local settings for all projects, especially for our research institute. Each project has completely different requirements on what the semantic media wiki has to do, which extensions have to be there, and then we have to think about the compatibilities of all the extensions. So there's still a lot of manual overhead which can't be done for all 100 projects. So what we're going to do is we want to develop a small application which reads all the local settings files for our projects and have one single management tool for all the wiki projects in one place. Now, as you can see here, we don't have only one code base because some extensions are not compatible with the code base. So we have to provide a number of different code bases and interlink the project wikis with the proprietary code base. And this we also want to do with our project management tool with the wiki management tool. For the reuse of vocabulary, right now you do that with templates. So we define templates for importing the vocabulary and define how they should look like within our wiki. So when we export the areas out of our wikis, we have a proper ontology with the correct name bases of the imported vocabulary. Okay, so for the requirement engineering is still ongoing work. So we have to capture, document, and manage the requirement of the customers. So especially for the industrial project, it is important to do that in a standardized way. So this also obviously we still have to work a little. And yeah, this should support for better requirement and analysis space for the project already. Yeah, of course the requirement engineering is also important for the success of the project to gain the customer certification. So yeah, right now it's done outside the MediaWiki, so we want to also include that in our okay, when we reach some stable status for our infrastructure, we want to extend it over our department. So right now it's only our IT division, especially process engineering, and all the other divisions that have different tools which they are used for project management, for quality management, for product management. And so as soon as we do have a shared infrastructure, then we also have plans to roll out to the other employees, so we have a huge or bigger user bases for